week on Cougar Media News.
We take a look into our Winter Spirit Week.
We talk more about the importance of Toys for Tots.
We learn about the importance of the share fridge.
Cougar Media News starts now.
What's up, PHS? This is Blake Deiter.
And Nate Osteen bringing you this week's episode of Cougar Media News. Toys for Tots is a cause to help kids in need. Senior Machia explained exactly how you can donate to this cause.
Toys for Tots is a national program that provides children of the less fortunate toys on Christmas.
Toys for Tots is a holiday drive that enables people to donate toys, books, hygiene products for families of need around the holiday season. Toys for Tots is very important because there's families in the area who just don't have the funds to provide a memorable holiday for their families. So people donating toys for these families give those families a chance to have a memorable holiday.
National Honor Society holds events in which students can deliver the boxes, supply toys, and more. However, any student can donate.
So any student can be involved by donating toys to their first period class. They'll have wrapped holiday boxes after Thanksgiving break, and you can just donate them in there. So officially it'll start after Thanksgiving break, so around November 28th, 29th, and it will go through about December 14th.
Make sure to get your donations in before December 14th. This has been Simone Bucher, Maddie Witt, and Lydia Harner reporting for Cougar Media News.
If you have any leftover and unused toys, remember to bring them and place them in the boxes throughout the school. Stall Day occurred Friday, November 17th. Students had fun stalling their teachers and raising money for kids with cancer. Staff members Richie Dune and Zach Risser recapped this event.
Stall Day is an event held each year for the Four Diamonds organization. This year, Stall Day was held on Friday, November 17th.
Stall Day is a day where students bring in cash and coins and teachers have to count them. While the teachers are counting them, the students can help doing their work. And all the money goes to FTK.
This year's Stall Day, $7,566.73 was raised, which is $700 more than last year's total.
We do Stall Days to raise money for Four Diamonds and to Song.
Thanks to everyone who participated in bringing money in for Stall Day.
The money goes towards families who are dealing with pediatric cancer, and it also deals with scientists who are trying to find cures for the cancer.
This is Zach Risser.
And Richie Dune, reporting for Cougar Media News.
Thanks to everyone who helped organize the event, to all the students who raised the most money in PHS history of Stall Day. Last year, the school started something new to try and save food from being thrown out. Ms. Stafford offered more information to staff member Jules Kautz.
Ever since COVID, PHS has provided something called the Share Fridge for students all around the school.
The Share Fridge allows us to take food that would have normally gone into the trash and share it with kids throughout the day who are hungry or need a snack. There are things in the Share Fridge that come from the student lunch, things that are wrapped and contained, like apple slices, fruits, vegetables, and pre-made snacks.
Many students stop by the Share Fridge whenever they're hungry. It's a great opportunity to eat something healthy for free.
We have a Share Fridge because students get hungry throughout the day and don't have access to food all the time. The Share Fridge helps students because it allows them to help other students by sharing snacks that they don't necessarily need. It also helps by preventing waste and keeping things out of landfills for future generations.
There are many people who participate in keeping the Share Fridge going.
Mrs. Ackright and her life skills class help with the collecting, stocking, and inventory for the Share Fridge. The Share Fridge is located on the second floor above the Cougar.
The Share Fridge is very helpful to the students in the school and even the community surrounding the school.
You can donate food to the Share Fridge by taking those wrapped items that you don't want at your school lunch and put them in the share bins. Then those will get cataloged and then they go into the refrigerator, and then we have a one-day turnover. So everything that goes in one day is gone by the end of the day.
This has been Jules Couch reporting for Cougar Media News.
If you have any food you don't want, be sure to put in the share fridge.
Now it's time for the Now You Know.
What's up, PHS? I'm with Maya Moore, and today we're going to be getting an inside look on this year's winter formal.
The winter formal is coming back this year. It's going to be on January 20th in the school cafeteria. More students can come this year because we did not reach capacity last year. We may also be adding a crowning. More details to come.
Now you know.
Thanks, Maddie and Maya. The annual holiday parade was on Saturday, November 18th. Lainey Crable attended this event and is here with the highlights.
The annual holiday parade was brought back to Palmyra this year, named as the Jack Frost Parade. The parade took place in the main streets of Palmyra on Saturday, November 18th from 11 to roughly 12.
I was in the holiday parade dancing with Palmyra Academy of Dance. We performed a dance and it was really fun. I've done the holiday parade every year that I've been able to since I was probably in third grade. So I was glad that they brought it back this year for my senior year.
I think the parade was a good idea because it brings Palmyra together and shows how great of a community we have.
The parade was put together to bring fun to the holidays and appreciate the tight-knit society Palmyra has put together. This has been Lainey Crabill reporting for Cougar Media News.
Thanks to everyone who participated in the parade. Spirit Week is a week to prepare for the holiday season and to have fun. Amanda Gettle and Tori Hepler show us what to wear throughout the week to participate in this year's holiday spirit.
Be sure to wear your Spirit Week clothes this week, guys.
Just a reminder that on Monday, December 4th, and Tuesday, December 5th, students will be taking the Keystone Literature exams. All students who are testing should report to their testing rooms by 7:50. All students who are not testing will be operating on a two-hour delay schedule. Good luck to all the students taking the test.
That's all we have for you this week, PHS.